In this video, I show you how to create a YouTube icon for your YouTube channel using a free Canva account. Your YouTube icon will appear on your channel's homepage as well as anywhere you comment. The picture needs to be square with a minimum size of 98 by 98 pixels, and its dimensions can be much larger but must be less than 4 megabytes in size. And if you are just jumping into this video right now, then you should know it's part of a series that I've put together taking you through everything you need to know to set up your YouTube channel in the very best way. I'll leave a link in the description below in case you want to check out the other videos. Now, to continue, you'll need a free Canva account. Those following along will have already created the account in the previous video, so I'm going to assume you've done or got a free Canva account as well. Let's jump over to the computer and get started. So here we are on our channel with our new banner that we created in the previous session. Now we're going to focus on creating a new icon, which will display just here. The first thing we need to do is log into Canva. So come up to your new browser tab and go into Canva and log in. Once you've logged in, come up to create a design. We want to create a custom size on this occasion, and we want the width to be anything greater than 98 by 98. I'm going to set mine at 500 by 500 and click create new design. Now, this stage is very much up to you about how you would like your channel icon to look. However, I recommend using your profile picture that you used on the larger banner in the previous example. So if you choose to do that, then come up to uploads and add your backgroundless image into your project. I'm going to make my image a bit larger and put him in the center of the screen. Now, the reason I suggest this is firstly, when you've got a picture with you looking at the screen, that attracts the user's attention a little bit more, and your face is obviously going to become your brand's identity. So if you have your face in your icon, then everybody knows when you are the person commenting or showing up in various places on YouTube. It doesn't technically have to be the same picture. It doesn't really matter. But if you've got two good quality pictures, then you can select a different one here. Now, theoretically, that would be enough. However, I feel like using a little bit of brand identity is also a good idea. So let's make it a little bit more interesting and have a semicircle coming over my body here at the bottom of the screen with my little logo in the center so everyone can see it's the right channel as well. To do that, come up to Elements, select the circle, bring it down and make sure it's the same size as your canvas. Now bring it down halfway and choose the color that you'd like it to be. If you've got brand colors, then this may be a good color to have as your brand colors. I'm going to choose white just to keep it simple. And I'm also going to move my picture to a little bit more in the center. Now there's a nice big space for us to put our logo, or in my case, just the initials of the channel. I'm going to come to text. I'm going to add in some text. I'm going to change the font to our recently used one, so it's the same font. And then my channel is Ultimate Gamer, but I'm going to use the initials Ultimate, or UG. That's obviously very small, so enlarge and center. Now, you're welcome to be very much more artistic than what I have done here, but you've got the two main elements that you might want to get into your channel icon. And remember that this is going to be massively shrunk down to only 100 pixels, or just under 100 pixels wide, and also show in a circular format. So if you wanted to mimic that circular format and just to see what's going to actually be visible, put a circle over your image and then use the transparency and just use a low transparency. So that circle that you now see around there is actually what's going to display on YouTube as your channel icon. If I just go back over to my icon, you can see that it's a circle it's not actually a square. You upload a square image, but you see the circle. So I hope that makes sense. I'm going to actually delete that circle because I don't want that as part of the image. That's how you identify what's going to get cut off at the corners. I'm going to save that and then download the image. It will save into your defaults download folder. Then you can come back over to your channel. And then if you're logged in and you're on your channel's homepage, you can simply click on the image and you'll get to the right location. If you're not there for any reason, then click onto the top right icon, go into your YouTube studio, come over to customization, and then click on branding. When you click on upload just here, you'll get to the same place. Select the image you just downloaded, and now you can see what's going to be visible on YouTube. Click done, and remember that's now uploaded, but it's not saved, so you won't see it on your channel until you click publish. Have a look at your channel, and you've now got your icon just down here. So I hope that's been helpful. In the very next video, we will go over the watermarks that appear on every video that you create. That's created at the channel level, and we're going to go over that in the very next video in the series. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.